case 7. A 50-year-old male with a history of smoking and hypertension with the severe chest pain radiating towards the back. What is the diagnosis? What is immediate medical treatment you will offer to the patient? And what should be the definitive treatment? First, look at the view. Again, the parasternal long axis view. You can see the aorta is dilated. How you comment on this view? In this view, normally the aorta and LH will be of equal size. But you can clearly appreciate in this view that ascending aorta is dilated as compared to the left atrium. With the highly mobile linear aquagenic density to the ascending aorta, with the color flow showing the aortic regurgitation, likely it is a type A aortic dissection with severe AR. What immediate medical treatment you will give, offer to the patient in ER? First, control the blood pressure, ideally with the IV beta blockers. Most superior is the IV labetalol. And the definitive treatment should send this patient immediately for the surgery. The patient needs the emergency surgery. Because with type A aortic dissection, there is a 1% increase in mortality with every hour. Now the case number 8. It's a 30-year-old male with the NYHA3 symptoms. What is the view? Apical 4-chamber view showing the severe right left ventricular dysfunction along with the right ventricular also reduced depressed function. Left atrium is dilated, right atrium is dilated. You can appreciate the clear spontaneous echo contrast into the left ventricle with the large echogenic density, layer density attached to the LV apex. With this LV dysfunction and akinetic LV apex, the likelihood is a thrombus. Another short axis view. This is the left ventricle. This is the RV apex. What are these two? The two mobile echogenic densities and the RV apex also. This patient also has the RV apical clot along with the left ventricular apical clot. Most of the time we focus on the left ventricle and miss the right ventricle. But whenever you are doing echo, always completely and thoroughly evaluate the right ventricle along with the apex. So what will be the medical treatment? Along with the guideline-directed anti-heart failure treatments like beta blockers, AC inhibitors, RNA, diuretic, you will have to add the anticoagulation in this patient. Now comes to the case number 9. A 45-year-old male with a fever for 1 month now came with NYHA class 3 symptoms. What are the echo findings and how will you manage this patient? Again, the most important view in the echo, the parasternal long axis view, showing the right ventricle, the left ventricle, the aortic valve, the left atrium. The left atrium is grossly dilated as compared to the aorta. And on the aortic valve, there is a linear mobile echogenic density attached at the aortic valve, causing the distortion of the aortic valve with clearly non-coptic aortic valve on the 2D. On the color, although not covering the LVOT, but it's showing the pizza formation. So just on the 2D image, you can comment that it will be the severe AR. And along with that, mild pericardial effusion. So this patient is acute infective endocarditis with the distortion of the aortic valve and the severe aortic regurgitation. Now how will you manage this patient? Along with the medical treatment, this patient should send for surgery because according to the ESC guidelines, the timing of the surgery in the left sided valve effective endocarditis means One of the criteria is aortic or mitral native vein endocarditis or postural vein endocarditis with severe regurgitation or obstruction, causing symptoms of heart failure or echocardiographic signs of poor hypohemodynamic tolerance, should send for surgery urgently. Now comes to the case number 10. The case of 30-year-old female came to the clinic with the recurrent palpitation. You advise echo, and these are the echo images. Again, the most important was the paraspinalongic CCU. View. What it's showing, as we see in the previous images, the LV should be larger than the RV or the LRV. But in this view, you can clearly see the hugely dilated right ventricle and the RVOT in this view. With a normal aortic valve, mitral valve, and a normal left ventricular function. Just from the basis of this image, what differential comes to the mind? Whenever the right ventricular is dilated, you have to look for the volume overload condition or the pressure overload condition or some congenital anomaly. What volume overload condition can cause this? Like the ASTs and types of AST, the partial and ominous venous drainage. And the pressure overload condition means the pulmonary stenosis, the primary pulmonary hypertension, severe pulmonary hypertension. But with the pulmonary hypertension, most of the time you have the right ventricular hypertrophy. But in this view, you don't have the right ventricular hypertrophy. Another possibility may be the congenital anomaly. Then you have to look for the other images also. Now this is the apical four chamber view of the same patient. What it's showing? It's showing the apical displacement of the septal leaflet of the tricuspid valve. You clearly appreciate this. Normally it should be less than 8 mm from the mitral valve, but it is widely displaced with a distorted septal leaflet, and the anterior tricuspid leaflet become elongated and sail-like, and the part of the RV become part of the right atrium, means the atrialization of the right ventricle with the non-coptic tricuspid valve, which should be the severe regurgitation. And the final diagnosis should be Epstein anomaly. And the what are the causes of palpitation in this patient? As we all know that with the Epstein anomaly, there are the multiple accessory pathways into the right atrium that can cause the AVRT. And these types of ARTs are the more difficult to control. Now I would like to end my presentation here with the thanks.